comes, here it comes. Hello everyone, welcome back to the Hunter Call of the Wild. This is the Hunter DD33, and in this video, I'm going to show you how to shoot the recurve bow accurately. Alright, so we're over here by the north end of Winnipeg, and we found a really nice bull. He's for surely gold potential. Awesome bull moose right out there. As well as there's some black-tailed deer over here as well. I think there's a buck. Yeah, there's a black-tailed buck there, and I'm pretty sure there's a couple decent black-tailed bucks right there. Now, we're going to go after them in a second, but first, I want to show where we're at. We're over here on the south end of Winnipeg, and our goal is to kind of swing around the right side here, and right here is where that moose was. So we have a good wind. I think if we get to this position here, we should be able to call this bull in. But first, I want to show you what you should most likely do as soon as you get the recurve bow. And I'm not sure if every lodge has these garbage cans, but these are a really great way to practice with the recurve bow. Now, we want to stand about 20 yards away from them, which is about what we're at right now. I'd probably recommend crouching just because you're going to get the least amount of wobble. And when you pull back, what you're going to want to do is you're going to see the left side of the broadhead right there. That's pretty much where the center of the animal is going to be. Now, you can't take a shot with the tip. What you're going to want to do is take that and make that in the center of the animal. But then you're going to want to go down to about the fifth line on your right of this bow here. And when you take a shot, you should be pretty level. Now, it's hard to stay drawn back, so I'm going to try and freeze the frame here, and I'll show you what I'm talking about. Alright, so if you look at the right, you can see the rope all the way down the recurve bow. Now, if you count up 5 or 6, between 5 and 6 is pretty much ideal at 20 yards out. So if you count 5 and then center the left side of that broadhead, you should be pretty accurate almost every single time. The wind doesn't seem to have too much effect on it either. Alright, so we hit just a touch low that time. So we'll want to go to 5 instead of 6. Yep, we're getting pretty accurate now. So now that we know the key, we should be able to make some nice shots. Now we're going to go over here and go see if we can't get this big bull and possibly find this black-tailed buck. Alright, there's our bull. He is about 240 yards away, a real nice gold potential bull, and we have a perfect wind. So now what we're going to try and do is get a little bit closer and cut the distance on this big bull. Unfortunately, we have a cot right there, and that's where all the bucks are. I was only able to spot that one. I can't quite get a spotting on the second one. Let's see, can we get it? Yeah, it's a three very easy, so they're both three very easies. There might possibly be another buck over there as well, but let's try and not walk in the water because the water makes quite a bit of noise. If you look at the right bottom right here, right next to the volume icon, you can see that it's pretty high up when we're in the water. So we don't want that to happen. That's a doe. But there's our big bull. He's right there looking right at us. Also, another thing, as soon as you spot an animal, it will show you this icon here. So anytime you want to know where it is, just check on the map. And you'll see this icon, that way you'll know exactly where he last was when you spotted him. So the cow moose should be, yeah, she's right there. Oh, the bull! The bull's right on top of us, guys. I did not know that he was coming in. All right, we gotta get ready on this. He snuck in way too fast. We got a bit of a strong wind. We don't really wanna pop up right now, but we might have to. All right, we're gonna draw back. We're gonna pop up and take a shot. Awesome shot on that bull. It looked really good. It looks like it was a vital hit. Now, that shot there was a little bit risky because he came in so fast. And this big of a bull, they don't stick around too long. So we had to take a shot fast, and we did. It looks like we centered him, ended up getting a liver shot. So you really can't complain about that too much at all. Yep, non-vital hit. That's a really good hit on a big bull moose for sure, especially with the recurve. So we'll track him down and see if we can't find this big bull. He would have been gold potential for sure, but even though that's not going to happen, I'm still just as happy because he's an awesome bull. We made a nice shot with the recurve bow. So he should be down just over here. And there he is down right there. an awesome bull moose down with the Hoyu recurve. Now, like I said before, he's not going to be gold because we hit him a little bit far back. We kind of played it safe, and it's way better to play safe than sorry, because if you try and go for a shoulder blade, double lung hard shot, and you hit that shoulder blade, you're just going to get flesh, and you're going to end up tracking this bull for a long ways. And since we played it safe, also we compensated for the wind as well. So let's take a look at this bull. He has a really nice spread, nice paddles on him, really symmetrical. Let's take a cool trophy shot of him, and then we'll pick him up and see what he's going to score. Now, I would imagine he's going to be probably a 180 plus. So we'll take a picture. Actually, that might not have been a great picture. That's your bird there. Okay. Now let's go up to him and go pick him up and see what he's going to score. He scores 174. We have a 0% quick kill, but he would have been for sure gold. Like you can see here, we hit a little bit far back. The wind was pushing to the right, so I was kind of holding left to compensate for that wind, but it seems like the wind doesn't really have much of an effect on this recurve bow anymore. At 17.7 yards out, if we would have hit a little bit more forward, we probably would have got double lung on that shot, maybe even heart, but still, not a bad shot on an awesome bull moose. All right, we do have another bull moose coming in. That's another nice bull, a real nice bull, four easy coming right in. Let's put some cover spray on real quick just to make sure he doesn't smell us. And we'll put our little call out one more time just to get him to come a touch closer. And we'll get our recurve ready. And he's about 25 out right there, so he's definitely in range. We are in pretty good camouflage here, so I don't think he can see us. But let's try and make a little bit better of a shot this time. More of a broadside. We're not going to cheat to the left side this time. We're going to go for double lung. All right, here we go. Okay, so we actually hit a little bit low. That second shot was really good, though. I think we got double lung the second time. Probably double lung. Because he was perfectly broadside. So let's pick up this track here. It was vital hit. And let's go track down this bull moose. I don't really want to run too much because there could be some nice bucks around here. We're just to the north of Willipeg right now. And there often happens to be some nice whitetail bucks around here. So we want to watch for them. That's kind of my ultimate goal, to find a decent buck. We have really good percentage going down here, and so far it looks like he went about 80, 90 yards out. So if he goes down within another 20 yards, he is possibly going to be a gold bull. But the way it's looking, that might not happen. Yep, there's our bull down right there. Yeah, that's a medium-sized bull, nothing special. Cow moose there. All right, we'll speed up the time here a little bit and go take a look at this bull. This was another really good bull. Probably going to be a 170 plus as well. So it looks like we had two chances at gold moose. We didn't quite get gold, but we still made a solid hit. And I'm happy with that, especially with the Hoyu recurve. Ooh. That was a pretty good shot. Might have been. No, because he was quartering away. So I thought we were a tad bit low, and we might have been maybe a half inch low. Probably up here would have been better, but still, a really nice shot, nice angle, and let's check. He scored 169, so yeah, we were just a touch far back, actually. We weren't really low as much as we were far back. I thought we would have gotten enough penetration to get through and get a double lung, but that was a 24-yard shot, so we hit a little bit low. Still got a nice bull moose and 961 cash. Another nice bull to hunt. I almost want to take a shot on this cow. We might. Nice hit on her. Big bull. Okay, I just saw a giant bull. That is not the same one. That's a diamond potential bull moose right there. Where did he come from? Holy, that thing's huge. Four easy, 183 to 245. That's a giant. He's not going to be diamond, but he's going to be 220s probably, close to it. That is an absolute giant of a bull moose. I haven't seen one that big in a long time. All right, guys, we have eyes on the big bull moose. He's right up here. I lost him for a second, but I just caught a glimpse of him. He's standing right there. He's right there. I don't think we have good camo here. We don't, but the bull is right there. About 96 yards out, coming right this direction. We have a tree right between us and him, and I think it'll work out perfect if we can get to this tree. So let's see if we can't slow him down and get him to come this direction. We'll put some cover spray on here just in case. In fact, it looks like he's kind of trotting away. Come on. Let's see if we can spot him. Oh, that is not our bull. That is not our bull. So where is our bull? It's not even close to our bull. Oh my God, he's right there. He's right there. Giant. Look at this thing. Oh, he's 71 yards out. We do have a tree here, but it's not much for cover. It's better than nothing, I guess. So we got a big bull there and a young bull there. And not great wind. We gotta be careful. We do not want to call too much. Here he comes. It's a bad angle. Oh, awesome shot. We just smoked a huge bull moose. That was awesome. All right, we're going to watch him. He took off this direction here. So he ran probably 100 yards. We're going to mark where we last saw him, about right here, which would give us a chance at this bull to be gold, because he's so big that even if he did round probably 200 yards, he still has a chance to be gold, because this is a monster bull. So let's go track him down. Holy, that thing was huge. Yep, according to this, he's about 100 yards away at this point. I would imagine we probably got single lung on him. But I am really happy with the angle that we had. We didn't really have too much to work with. And we made it happen. So let's see. He's down right here. So who knows what he's going to be. I do see some deer out here, so I want to make a... Yeah, tiny whitetail buck. That's all I've been seeing lately. That's what it seems like anyways. But our huge bull moose is down right here. Oh, this thing is huge. Let's pat down the grass on this one and take a look at him. Too bad his horn wasn't up on the other side there, but we'll just deal with what we have here. It seems like every time you get something huge, it just ends up halfway into the ground. Still an awesome picture though. You can see how wide his paddle is there. And also, look at the arrow. Really nice shot. We came a little bit close to that front shoulder, but we took a chance and got lucky. We got really lucky. So let's pick up this bull and see who's going to score. He scores 211, and we made a right lung shot on him. Total score of 764, so he for sure would have been gold. But we got a single lung on him. He was a 4 easy and just an awesome bull to take with the recurve. This is the biggest animal I've taken with the recurve so far. And you can see we were literally about a half an inch from making a heart lung shot on this giant bull moose. All right, guys. Well, I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and I hope you found it helpful. If you guys liked it, please give it a thumbs up. Thank you guys so much for watching, and we'll see you next time. That's a monster. 159 to 213 score estimate, and 187 to 220 pounds on that buck. Let's go with that and let's pick him up. Oh my God, a 210 scoring diamond whitetail buck. I can't believe he was that big.